Now there is a term master boot record. What master boot record is? Whenever, if you remember, a disk starts or a computer actually starts, you know that ROM memory is accessed first so that the booting can happen. But for booting, a record is needed. Why? Just because ROM doesn't know that where in the disk actually the operating system is stored. So what happens in your operating system, in your disk actually, on the very first sectors, there is a record stored which is called as MBR. That MBR stores that particular information, that which partition of your disk, where in actually sector and track the actual operating system is stored. So a master boot record, MBR, is a special type of boot sector, the very first sector at very beginning of the partitioned computer mass storage device. Mass storage device means your hard disk. And it contains the information regarding how and where the operating system is located in the hard disk so that it can be booted in the RAM memory. Somebody is asking, sir, please do not make the videos private. Yes, we will not. We will not make any video private. If you are learning, only two things we need from your end. Like and share the series with all of your friends. Second, if you follow any series, drop your comment on the very first video of the series so that the people who are going to start that series will know that what kind of series this particular one is. Your review for sure will help lots of other members to think that what kind of series it is. Okay. चलिए आगे बढ़ते हैं. Unix का inode होता है. That structure is also we need to study. Not much. What is inode? Inode is nothing but an index node, a data structure which Unix style file system stores. How and why? Why they store? Just to have such kind of indexing. In the indexed allocation, what I told, we will be having a block. That block will be storing the index of all the what? All the blocks which are used for the storage. Similarly, Unix based or Unix style ka jo file system hai, all those will be using a data structure which is called as index node or inode. That data structure will store the file system storage or file system information, that which block is stored, where it is stored, etc., etc., indexing and some other information about file and directories. Directory means folder. Now, there are few information which you need to understand here. Each node stores the attributes and disk block location. Disk block location means indexing of the object ka data. Object means file ka data. So what are the attributes? Attributes means some kind of what is the number of the file or name of the file, etc., etc. Some information is there. We don't have to remember all these. The number of inode limits the total number of files or directory. So a Unix style file system can have fixed number of inodes. Let's say we can have total 16 inodes only. So one inode can store the information about one file. Hence total maximum 16 file only you can have. So it can be possible that number of inodes will limit the total number of files or directories that can be stored in a particular file system. It is possible. Ab is inode mein hota kya hai? First of all, administrative information. Permission that who can open the file, etc., etc. Timestamps that when a particular file got created, last updated, etc., etc. Number of direct blocks. Direct block means direct block numbering, that which block is used to store this file. Typically, there are 12 blocks, direct blocks, that these are the 12 blocks to store the particular file. Now, if the file size is more than 12, then we will need a single level indirect pointer. Indirect pointer means that points to a disk block. So that pointer means a block number. That block number will carry me, will particular block number bring me to a block. That block stores the indexes. That block stores the indexes like a single level indexing. Then a double indirect pointer means if with single indirect pointer or single level directory, if we cannot we cannot store entire file, then we will have to go for double indirect pointer also, and one indirect triple indirect pointer is also there if suppose up to two level also you are not able to store the entire file. Right, so depends on the file. If file can store on only 12 blocks, then only direct pointers or direct block numbering will help. If not, then a single indirect pointer will be needed. If that is also not enough, then double pointer also needed. If that is also not enough, then triple pointer. Isse zyada bada file nahi hoga. You will not have more than that file, of course. It's too big. Too big. Understood? Okay, now listen, there is a question which we are going to solve, and you will understand how to solve. Very easy. This kind of question, actually two times they have asked. In 2004 also, kind of similar kind of question they have asked. In index node, inode of a Unix-like file system has 12 direct, one single indirect and one double indirect pointer. Okay, good. The disk block size is 4 kilobyte and disk block address is 32 bit. Disk block address 32 bit and block size 4 kilobyte. Can you tell me how many number of entries we can have? Number of disk indexes in a single block. In a single block. How many entries you can keep? Single block size 4 kilobyte. Each block numbering you will have to keep of 32 bits. 32 bits means 4 bytes. 1K, 2 power 10. 2 power 10 number of entries you can keep. Okay, now what exactly the file is stored on? 12 direct, one single indirect and one double indirect pointer. Okay, so maximum file size will utilize all the blocks. So maximum file size will be equal to first of all 12 direct pointers. So 12 direct pointer, each pointer will lead me to have one block of 4 kilobyte plus one single indirect. Single indirect means 2 power 10 pointers. Each pointer will lead me to have a block of 4 kilobyte plus one double indirect. Double indirect means 2 power 10 index blocks. Each index block containing 2 power 10 indexes and each index will be of a block of 4 kilobyte. When you calculate this, answer is asking 4 GB rounded off to one decimal place, you will get almost 4.0 GB. ये बहुत छोटा है GB. This is the largest one. 2 power 10 into 2 power 10 into 2 power 10, 4. Remaining things will be very, very small in terms of GB. So answer will be 4.0 GB. कितना easy. So easy it is. So easy, but you need to know the concept and you need to remember how to utilize the concept so that you can solve the question. Right now, fine. After 2 months, gone. Somebody was asking, sir, you teach same to same on Unacademy Plus also and you teach same to same on YouTube also. What's the difference? Difference is when you attend my Plus class live, you will understand what kind of structure you have. Now you understood, fine. But what if I will give you 6 to 10 questions based on whatever you have learned today? And then at the weekend, I will conduct a test and that particular test will have questions of gate quality. Of course, your learning will be in a better way that, oh, how to solve the question using this knowledge, what we have gained today. It's very different kind of experience, which nobody can learn until you go through that particular actual learning model. You don't understand just because you are not so expert in such kind of thing. So you feel like, okay, I am understanding everything means in the gate, I will be able to perform well, but everybody cannot do that. For that, you will have to learn the art of problem solving, which consists 80% of your learning. 20% learning is just understanding the concept. 80% of actual learning is how to utilize your learning and the concept to solve the problem. In the gate, you will have to solve the problem. And when you learn that particular method, you will be on the top of the world. When you do not, you can't understand by yourself every single day.
It's time to experience something glorious. Unacademy Combat. Compete, crack, conquer.
A challenging GATE contest engineered to give you an experience like none other.
Where you put your knowledge to test.
And battle it out with the best.
To bring out the best in you.
Unacademy Combat is the most competitive, gamified contest for GATE till date. With the best of the questions by best educators.
With detailed video solutions from top educators right after each contest.
Combat live with peers to get real-time rankings and win big.
Participate in every contest to improve your ratings.
Challenging contests every fortnight or alternate Sunday. Live ranking after every question. Big rewards for top rankers. Your passion to crack GATE deserves this. Your hard work towards your dream deserves this. Fuel your inner fire for the ultimate GATE challenge. Unacademy Combat. Register now.